Hello students, we are dealing with the microbes in human welfare, and in this section we will discuss the importance or significance of microbes with respect to the sewage treatment. Let's see what is the sewage. So sewage is basically a wastewater which is being collected from the household activities in the form of both liquid and solid waste, and it is created day by day in a large amount. So the sewage basically contains large amount of domestic waterborne waste including human and animal excreta, washing waters, microbes, many of which can cause disease and acting as a causal agent for disease and spreading these disease in the environment, and everything that enters the sewerage system comes under the category of sewage. So you will be surprised to know that lot of gallons, or you can say in terms of, you can say, the calibration level of the water which is being produced in our cities, it's so large that it comprises approximately 30% of the urban areas and 20% of the sewage production is disposed of properly after proper treatment, and the rest remains untreated, and it is basically thrown off, or you can say released directly into the water bodies like rivers or ponds or nearby lakes. So it's a major concern why we need to study this topic, and how microorganisms, they are helpful in treatment of the sewage. So let's see what is there in the next section of this slide. This is about the composition of the sewage. So basically sewage, it consists of approximately 99% of the water and 1% solid waste. Here I have mentioned 10%, so please rectify this. So it contains basically 99% of water and 10% solid waste, including the organic and inorganic matter. So the microorganisms which are generally present in sewage water include mostly the E. coli, that is Escherichia coli species, it's a bacteria, then Streptococcus, Clostridium, Lactobacilli, etc. And many more forms of the micro fungi, protozoans, micro algae are also there, which are forming the part of sewage composition. And these microorganisms, basically they carry out the biological activities which helps the sewage to get treated itself in a natural way. So let's see what are the methodologies of sewage treatment as per the municipalities which they are using in our cities. So there are basically two methods for the treatment of sewage. One is primary method and the second one is secondary method. So let's discuss these methods one by one. See, you can see here the primary method, where a picture is being shown here. So what happens in this case? The primary treatment of sewage is mostly mechanical and concerned mainly with the removal of coarse material, that is the solid material, from the filtrate, that is the sewage water, through filtration and sedimentation. As you can see, the influent, which is the sewage water, which is being filtered out by using the large screens, which is shown here in the picture. So two screens are being shown here, and water which contains some grit or solid particles, it is being settled out in the grit chamber, and other finer particles, they are being sedimented in the sedimentation tank, and rest of the water which is which carries no solid waste, it is being released out through the in the form of effluent. So first of all, the sewage is diluted with water and it is passed through a series of filters of sequentially small pore size to remove large floating objects like polythene bags. Then the filtered sewage is passed into the grit chamber. You can see the grit chamber where the coarse solid material, that is sand, pebble, are settled down by the gravity. So this is sedimentation process. You have already studied this in your lower classes, what is sedimentation. After this, the sewage is allowed to pass into the sedimentation tank where most of the suspended materials, they settle down. So it takes a bit longer time as compared to the previous chamber. This concentrated solid material that settles down forms the primary sludge. So sometimes questions they are asking, what is primary sludge and what is secondary sludge. So now you may pay attention for the definition for these two terms. What is the basic difference between the primary sludge and secondary sludge? So the effluent is then taken for the secondary treatment, and that is basically the water. Now the next step, you can say, or the method for the treatment of the sewage water is secondary treatment. As you can see here, the picture is being shown in the form of the different steps through which the sewage water is being treated off. So basically, the secondary treatment of liquid effluent from primary settling tank is purely biological treatment. Here only the significance of microbial activity you need to think, and the attention should be paid in this way. So first of all, the effluent is passed into the large aeration tanks where it is constantly agitated by the mechanical systems of the machines which are used for this process. The air is allowed to pass through the agitation mixture to make it aerobic. This helps several aerobic bacteria, or you can say microbes, to grow and oxidize the organic matter present in the sewage. So this is the natural way of treatment which these organisms they are being doing to clean up the sewage water. So the aerobic microbes, which consist of the microalgae like chlorella, microfungi, bacteria, including E. coli and all, E. coli is the pollution causing bacteria, so and many other protozoans. So these aerobes grows in flocks and they consume a major part of the organic matter, so that the biological oxygen demand of sewage is reduced. Now the effluent is passed through the sedimentation tank where the microbial flocks are allowed to settle down. The settled material here is basically known as activated sludge. The activated sludge is collected and subjected to anaerobic digestion in a separate tank. This tank has oxygen-free atmosphere where the anaerobic microorganisms start digesting the bacteria and fungi in this sludge. The anaerobic microorganisms digest the organic matter into soluble substances and gases, which basically releases the mixture of methane, carbon dioxide and hydrogen sulfide, and this gas is highly inflammable and useful, and you know this, the name of this gas, obviously it's a biogas. So finally, the treated sewage effluent is subjected to chemical treatment for disinfection before releasing into the natural water bodies. So this was all about the secondary treatment which our municipalities they are doing for the treatment of the sewage water. Now what was the harmful effect if the sewage, it was not if we are not going to treat the sewage in a proper way? So most of the sewage water, they are the source for disease causing microbes which are present in the sewage water, and when spread in the environment can cause diseases. Likewise, if untreated, the sewage water, it produces offensive odors which is unbearable and also not good for health. It also increases the biological oxygen demand if it is mixed with the water body. So the organisms living in the water bodies, they are in you can say they require oxygen, and they are not getting that oxygen in a proper way. So it increases their biological oxygen demand. So broad level of the water body that gets amplified. So what is biochemical oxygen demand? It is the amount of dissolved oxygen which is needed by the aerobic biological organisms to break down their organic material. Likewise, it is needed for the respiration process in a given water sample at certain temperature over a specific period. So it's very, very important for us to know that when biological oxygen demand is high for a water body, it's an alarming situation. So we need to tackle that situation because it could lead to the death of or you can say destruction of most of the biological species which are going inside the that particular water body, natural water body. So we should be very careful while disposing of the sewage, untreated sewage water directly into the water bodies. So it was all about the harmful effects of the sewage. Likewise, what is the basic significance of the sewage treatment? So various initiatives have been taken. So prior to the year 1985, only few cities and towns had sewage treatment plants. So most of the sewage water of urban as well as rural areas were discharged directly into the rivers, resulting in their pollution. So importance of microbial treatment of sewage was then realized, and more sewage treatment plants were established. Still, they are not sufficient due to increasing urbanization and production of much larger quantities of sewage compared to the earlier days. So realizing the importance of microbes in pollution control, Ministry of Environment and Forest, they have initiated development of sewage treatment plants under National River Conservation Authorities, and for such treatment they have different sort of plans for different rivers. So one such plan is Ganga Action Plan, which was started in the year 1986 with the main objective of pollution abatement. To improve the water quality by interception and diversion and the treatment of domestic sewage and the present toxic and industrial chemical waste from the identified grossly polluting units entering into the river. And its main objective was to improve the water quality by the interception. So it was all about the Ganga Action Plan, and we also have the Yamuna Action Plan. This plan is a bilateral project between the government of India and Japan, which was introduced in the year 1993. It is one of the largest river restoration projects in the India. So this section of information which the video is carrying is basically pertaining to the biological species. So which you should understand that the biological stage where these microorganisms, they are helping us to get rid of the harmful effects of the sewage water, which is when going to mix with the natural water bodies, going to cause a lot of complications for the human society. So some such examples of the microbial organisms which are helpful for digesting the organic waste in the form of you can say the pollutants or the solid waste which are present in the sewage water, which has been treated by these organisms. So you can see the examples of those organisms. So Chlorella pyrenoides is one of such example. Micro fungi are also there, bacterial species are there, protozoans are there, which are helpful for the treatment of the sewage water. So this video or you can say the concept clarification which I just want to mention in this video is basically the it is related to the significance of the microbial agents which naturally clean up the sewage water or untreated water. So we should know the significance and importance of such microbial species for our own survival. That's it. Thank you.